when the day is through. Who makes stories when the day is through? Story makers, story makers, working through the night till the rising sun. Story makers, story makers, stories are fabulous, stories are fun. Milton Wordsworth, Jenny and Jackson, working through the night till the rising sun. Story makers, story makers, stories are fabulous, stories are fun. Come on, be a story maker. Story makers.
Hello.
Has everybody gone?
The sun is down, the stars are bright. Story makers come out at night. Milton Wordsworth, story maker and magical maestro, at your service.
Milton, Milton, it's very cold and white outside.
Snow, my dear chap.
Oh, but where does snow come from?
Well, it comes from water. Ooh. When water gets cold, it freezes into snow and ice.
So if I want to find out about snow, I must first find out about water.
Well, technically, yes, I suppose so. But you don't have to really, because you already know about what...
Look, I found an empty vase. We have to imagine the water. And now you have to use your imaginations and imagine a story. Imagine, imagine, imagine a story. Oh, look, it's working. It's a playbook. And it's called Water Play.
Today, the children are playing in the garden. They are making boats ready for a boat race. They cut up old plastic cartons and use sticky tape and corks to make their boats float. Dominic pumps the water into a tray ready for the race. Here they go. Will their boats float? Yes! Now ready? Go! Dominic's the winner. Alice prefers something a little quieter. She likes to listen to the glistening purple water trickle through a sieve. Playing with the water is Hisham and Purusha's favourite thing. They play a measuring game. Who can fill up their buckets the quickest? Whoa, watch it slide. Purush has won. Nakai also loves playing with the water. She likes to scoop it up and watch it tumble through a funnel and turn the water wheel very quickly. Hisham has found a bright plastic frog. The only problem is that the frog has lost a leg and can only swim round in circles. Everybody look for the missing leg. No, it's not here. There it is. Well done. Time for another boat race. Oh, Purush has won again. Everybody loves playing with soap in the water. The soap is slippery and slimy, and it jumps out of the children's hands. The water turns a creamy colour, and the soap makes fantastic bubbly hands.
So if you can play with water, can you play with snow?
Why, most certainly. Oof. You can build a snowman or a snow cat.
Or a snow Jackson.
It's a good idea. Hey, what's going on?
Or you can have snowball fights. When's gone into the toy machine? When is the
space. Kevin and Spanner in space to explore, seeking out planets never heard of before.
Kevin and Spanner had landed on a new planet. The surface was covered in white and crunchy snow. It was rather cold. Growled Spanner, shivering. Kevin was warm as toast inside his spacesuit. He wondered why Spanner was shaking. Come on, Spanner, he said. Let's explore. Spanner shivered again. Icicles were beginning to form on his tail. The planet was very quiet, and there were no plants or trees in sight, just more crunchy whiteness. Where is everybody? Said Kevin. We're supposed to be making friends. Just then, something hit Kevin on his spacesuit. It was a snowball. Splat! Spanner was hit by a snowball too. Kevin looked round to see who had thrown them, but he couldn't see anyone. Only more whiteness. Spanner had spotted something though. He went over to a huge white mound and started scratching at it.
Oh, hey, stop it! You're tickling me!
Said an icy voice. The mound turned round. Spanner was so surprised, he forgot to shiver. It was a snowman.
Ah, a monster!
Yelled the snowman. He's not a monster, he's a dog, said Kevin.
Ah, a dog!
Yelled the snowman. He's quite harmless, said Kevin. He's called Spanner, and I'm Kevin. Who are you?
Snowman,
said the snowman. Snowman who? Asked Kevin politely.
Just Snowman, said the snowman. Everyone's called Snowman on planet Ice,
said Spanner, and wagged his tail.
Afternoon,
came a chorus of shivery voices. Several more snowmen had arrived while Spanner wasn't looking.
Let's play snowballs, they suggested.
Kevin loved playing snowballs, and so did the snowmen. Spanner tried to join in too, but dogs aren't very good at throwing snowballs. Finally, the game was over. The snowmen were tired out and waved goodbye as they settled down to sleep. Nice to meet you, said Kevin, as they heard the first frosty snore. Spanner whined. He was hungry. Come on, Spanner. Let's see if we can find you a bone back in the rocket, said Kevin. Spanner wagged his tail. Planet Ice had been chilly, but fun.
Snowball fights are cool.
And snowmen are even cooler.
Yeah.
Oh, the snow is brilliant.
Mm.
Jelly, Jackson, look at these. The children have been some snowy pictures.
Mm.
Look, here's a collage of a snowman.
Oh, we just made a story about the snowman.
Yeah. Wonderful. Mm.
And what are those children doing?
They're skiing.
Oh.
But you can only do that when it snows on rather big mountains like these.
It looks a bit scary to me.
Mm. What about this one? It's a picture of people ice skating.
That looks like fun.
Yeah. Oh, it is, young fellow, me lad. You can glide and skate along, swooshing over the ice. You can jump and twirl and swish and swirl. Oh, it's such fine sport.
Well, can we have a story about it, then?
Oh, yes, can we? Can we?
Why, certainly. I'll just skate over to the machine. Back in a tick. You know what to do, don't you? Imagine a story. It's a blue cow story. And it's called Blue Cow at the Ice Rink.
In a field not far away is a herd of cows grazing quietly. One of the cows is most unusual. Blue Cow wonders about the big world beyond her field. One day, Blue Cow was thinking about the winter.
I wonder what it's like to walk on ice.
She's off again, said all the other cows.
So Blue Cow caught the bus that stops beside her field.
I'd like a return ticket to somewhere icy, please.
There you go, madam. Hold very tight.
And they set off for an ice rink. when they arrived, Blue Cat got off the bus. She could hardly believe her eyes. It was amazing. The ice rink was like a huge field of beautiful ice. It glistened under the lights, and it looked very slippery. Blue Cow wobbled from hoof to hoof, and wondered if she would ever be able to stand up on it at all.
Need some of these,
called an old man from behind a big counter, as he waved a pair of ice skating boots at Blue Cow.
Oh, I see, of course I do,
Blue Cow.
The
man gave Blue Cow an odd look as he gave the boots. It took ages to do up all the laces and all four boots, but eventually, Blue Cow was ready to skate. Blue Cow nervous. Is it yourself? Torvill glided up to her.
It is me, as my partner, he turned up.
So Torvill helped keep Wood and Wibble. She was standing.
Now for some fun, said Torvill. Hold on tight.
They were off. Torvill skated around the rink and Blue Cow followed. At first she was scared, but then she glided and twisted and turned. And soon she was whizzing round the rink so fast and so gracefully. Then Torvill jumped and Blue Cow jumped too.
What natural, said Torvill.
People just stopped and watched.
Haven't you ever seen a cow skating before?
Blue Cow thought. But they must have liked her, because when Blue Cow and Torvill stopped skating, everyone threw flowers onto the rink for them.
You'll never guess where I've been.
Where have you been?
I've been to an ice rink and skated around all afternoon.
Everyone knows cows can't go ice skating.
But we know they can, don't we?
I'd be good at ice skating, I'm sure.
Me too. But look outside. It's getting lighter. Oh,
the children will be able to play in the snow on their way here.
Yes, they'll be having snowball fights.
And they might even build a snowman. Yes.
There's a plethora of things to do when it's snowy. Ooh. But the dawn is upon us. The morning is nigh. We've made our story, and we bid you goodbye.
Story makers, working through the night till the rising sun. Story makers, story makers, stories are fabulous, stories are fun.
Bye, story makers.
See you again soon.